Hello, and thank you for using the BQ76960. This video will walk you through the basics of creating your schematic, help you to avoid common mistakes, and direct you to the best resources you need for any questions not directly answered in this video. Let's start by taking a quick look at the BQ76940 product folder. Here you will find a few important documents to keep handy while creating your schematic. The most critical documents you will need are the device data sheet and the BQ76960 family top design considerations app note. Other useful documents are the FAQ and the EVM user's guide. Another resource that is extremely helpful are the TI reference designs using the BQ76960 device. I have listed 5 reference designs here that are available today. You can find these reference designs under the Tools and Software tab in the product folder, or you can click on any of the above links to visit the reference designs directly from this video. New TI designs become available each year, so make sure to check the product folders on ti.com for new examples. The first step in the schematic design is selecting the appropriate device number for your system needs. The main part of the part number determines whether you are selecting the 5-cell, 10-cell, or 15-cell version of the device, but the last 2 digits of the part number designate other important details that should not be overlooked. These digits determine the I2C address, the LDO output voltage, and whether CRC is enabled or not on the I2C communication. Be sure to select the correct device part number that meets the needs of your system. Okay, let's go through the basic schematic connections, and I will point out things to watch out for along the way. Here we are looking at the 15S BQ76940 device. Let's start with the connection for VSS. VSS will connect to the bottom of the lowest battery cell, which we commonly refer to as BAT minus, which is the ground reference for the battery electronics. This is different from the negative terminal of the pack, which will connect to BAT minus through a current sense resistor and protection FETs if using low side protection. The cap pins each need a 1 microfarad capacitor. For cap 1, it is between cap 1 and ground. For cap 2, it is between cap 2 and VC5X. And for cap 3, it is between cap 3 and VC10X. These pins should not be used to supply power to other external circuits. For the BQ76930 and BQ76940, there are pins labeled NC, or no connect, that you may notice in the datasheet pin tables that actually do need a connection. This is easy to miss because of the confusing pin names. Make sure to follow the datasheet pin table instructions for these pins like shown here. The REGOUT pin needs a capacitor of at least 1 microfarad. This pin supplies power to the controller IC. Next, let's look at the pins that communicate with the host controller. The regulator output pin supplies power to the host controller, and the BQ76960 operates as an I2C slave, so pull-up resistors are required on the SCL and SDA lines. Verify that your controller VCC and I/O pin voltages are compatible with the version of the BQ76960 device you selected. The alert pin should also be connected to the controller to provide interrupts when a fault condition is present or a new measurement is available. Make sure to connect the recommended pull-down resistor and a filter capacitor close to the device. The capacitor is not mentioned in the datasheet, but it is used on many of the TI reference designs as it can help protect this pin from noise to prevent false interrupts to the host. For the alert pin, also be sure to follow the datasheet recommendations regarding layout. The BQ76960 device has 1-3 TS pins for connecting to external thermistors. A 10 kiloohm NTC103AT thermistor should be used, and each thermistor should be connected between the TS pin and the cell group ground reference. The thermistors should be connected between TS1 and VSS, TS2 and VC5X, and between TS3 and VC10X. If external thermistors are not used on any of these pins, the thermistor should be replaced with a 10 kiloohm resistor and should not be left floating. The TS1 pin also functions as a boot pin for the device to wake up the device from shutdown mode. It is important to provide a rising voltage above the boot threshold voltage for this pin. In the picture above, this is accomplished using a push button switch, which is the way it is implemented on the evaluation board. However, this may need to be controlled differently for different end applications. Please refer to the app note, BQ76960 Boot Switch Alternatives, for a detailed discussion on different boot methods. The SRP and SRN pins connect to a current sense resistor to enable current measurement. The SRP pin connects to the battery ground side of the sense resistor, and the SRN pin connects to the pack minus terminal side of the sense resistor. An input filter is connected between the sense resistor and the device inputs. The resistance value of the sense resistor should be selected to maximize the range of the Coulomb counter, but it should also consider the overcurrent and short circuit detection thresholds and allow some tolerance margin. The detailed design procedure section of the datasheet walks through a step-by-step example for choosing an optimal sense resistor for an application. For your board layout, make sure to place the sense resistor components very close to the IC. If current sense is not used, the SRP and SRN pins should be connected directly to VSS. The REG source pin is a power supply separate from the BAT pin. It is the input supply for the output LDO, and it is used to power the FET outputs. For the BQ76920, the REG source pin can be powered with the same voltage as the BAT pin. Some applications even connect these two pins directly. For the BQ76930 and the BQ76940, a source follower circuit is needed, where the FET is used to provide current to the REG source input from the positive battery terminal while reducing the voltage to a value within the voltage range for the pin. The FET dissipates power from the load current, so care should be taken to select a FET with the proper power dissipation ratings. There is a very detailed discussion on the REG source supply in the top design considerations app note. The datasheet gives a detailed description of how to connect the discharge and charge pins to drive the low-side FETs. There is also a very detailed discussion in the FET drive section of the top design considerations app note. Some applications may benefit from using high-side FETs. For example, if continuous communication is needed between a host controller and a monitor, regardless whether the FETs are on or off. For high-side FET driving, the BQ76920 high-side FET driver may be used with the BQ76960 monitor family. Two of the existing TI designs use this configuration for high-side FET driving and are good examples to follow. If unused, the discharge and charge pins may be left unconnected. The VC pins are the sense voltage pins for the cell voltage measurements. The battery cells connect to the VC pins through RC filters. The component values for these filters differs for the BQ76920 and the higher cell count devices due to a difference in the device architectures. The EVM uses a large input filter resistors to reduce the transient voltages to the inputs, but large resistors limit the cell balancing current. When selecting the RC values for the cell inputs, refer to the datasheet recommended values and carefully read the cell balance section of the top design considerations app note. If higher balancing current is needed, this device supports external balancing. The cell balancing section of the top 10 design considerations app note shows examples for both N-channel and P-channel FET circuits. There are a few important things to take note of when making cell connections. First, notice that the VC1 and VC0 capacitors both should connect to ground. This is something users sometimes overlook, and it may reduce the accuracy of the bottom cell measurement. Notice the same pattern for the bottom of each of the cell groups. VC6 and VC5B filter caps both reference VC5X, and VC11 and VC10B both reference VC10X. Also, make sure to include the diode connections to the cell group supply pins. A diode should not be used for the BQ76920, but should be used for the BQ76930 and BQ76940. These should be placed between VC5 and VC5X, between VC10 and VC10X, or BAT if using the BQ76930, and between VC15 and BAT. Finally, it's very important not to forget the filter components for each supply pin. Notice there is a required connection from the point between cell groups to the supply pin through an RC filter. Point A connects through the filter to the VC5X pin. Point B connects through its filter to the VC10X pin, and the top of the stack connects to the BAT pin through its filter. Notice that the filter caps lie between the BAT and VC10X, VC10X and VC5X, and VC5X and ground. The BQ76960 family of ICs supports a variety of cell counts. Be sure to refer to the datasheet tables for information on how to connect the unused VCX pins. Here's the datasheet table for the BQ76930. If we were to create a schematic for the 8-cell battery, we would make our connections according to the third column by shorting VC9 to VC8 and VC4 to VC3. Refer to TI Design 010030 for an example schematic using 13 cells with the BQ76940. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video has helped you get started on your battery pack design using the BQ76960.